The new news now uses the right 40% yield, which is the same as Samsung's current 2-nanometer chip manufacturing. After this fix, the Exynos 2600's Geekbench 6 scores are now said to be around 2950 for single-core and 10,200 for multi-core. The 3D Mark and GFXBench performance results are still the same as they were before. The Galaxy S26, the company's next S-series phone, is already in the works. It could employ a new CPU called the Exynos 2600. Early rumors say that the Exynos 2600 processor might make the Galaxy S24 more faster and more powerful. Leaker Orexta, a trustworthy source, has revealed some information regarding this new CPU. People say that the Exynos 2600 is made using 2-nanometer technology, which is more efficient than previously. It might contain 2 strong Cortex-X cores and a 6 Cortex-A cores. The Exynos 2600 might get scores of around 2,400 in single-core tests and 9,400 in multi-core tests in early testing on Geekbench. That suggests it might be roughly 20% faster in single-core and 15% quicker in multi-core performance than the Exynos 2400. Moreover, the Xclipse 960 GPU seems interesting. It may score 5,803 DMARC Wildlife Extreme and get 85 frames per second in the GFXBench Aztec Ruins test. This means smoother visuals and better gameplay on the phone. If these things are true, the Galaxy S26 might be significantly quicker and better at gaming than prior versions. They haven't announced anything yet, but the Galaxy S26 is slated to ship in early 2026. We'll certainly learn more about the Exynos 2600 and Galaxy S26 series in the coming months. Next, the One UI 8.5 development for Galaxy S26 series has already begun. And Samsung has yet to showcase its 7th generation foldables, but the Galaxy S26 series, expected to appear in January next year, has already entered the rumor mill. This time it's about software. After a delay with the One UI 7, Samsung apparently bypassed One UI 7.1 for its future foldables and rushed right to One UI 8, which was initially scheduled to be a big component of January's Unpacked presentation. With leaks showing little hardware upgrades for the S26 series, and all of this looks to be moving its attention to software once again. Whispers about the One UI 8.5, the software expected to power these 2026 flagships, indicate Samsung is cooking up something significant. With work allegedly started, might this mid-cycle upgrade take the attention from competitors like Apple's iOS 26? Samsung has discreetly begun firmware work for One UI 8.5 and built on Android 16. The One UI 8.5 also follows the One UI 8.0 and signals a return to Samsung's historical pattern of large mid-cycle upgrades, such the S5 versions seen up to One UI 2. Unlike prior years, when the One UI 6.1 and the 7.0 bypassed significant mid-cycle updates in favor of modest improvements, the One UI 8.5 apparently promises to be a considerable jump. Its presence was also hinted at in a secret menu inside the One UI 7, fueling suspicion. While information on features remain under wraps, the One UI 8.5 is anticipated to deliver a sophisticated user experience, perhaps rivaling Apple's design-heavy iOS 26. The One UI 8.5 is rumored to be positioned as a gap filler to keep Galaxy devices competitive until the next major OS cycle. The upgrade may also spread out to earlier smartphones, with the Galaxy S25 series likely receiving the complete range of new capabilities, while select improvements might reach the S24, the S23, and possibly the S22 series. Samsung's early work on the One UI 8.5 reveals ambitious expectations for the Galaxy S26 series, aiming to surpass competition with a sophisticated software experience. As Apple launches iOS 26, could Samsung's mid-cycle upgrade offer Galaxy customers the advantage in 2026? We're interested to see what's next. A lack of meaningful modifications is somewhat of a trend for this series of leaks, as the same source also states that the S Pen and its dedicated slot will stay, which is maybe predictable, although they caution that future versions may not have a slot for the stylus. And they also suggest that the Samsung Galaxy S26 Ultra won't feature a magnetic ring to work with Qi2 charging and magnetic attachments. This is the same scenario as with the Samsung Galaxy S25 Ultra, which enables you to utilize those capabilities, but only if you place the phone in a suitable case, with the magnets being incorporated into the case rather than the phone. With the potential exception of eliminating the S Pen slot on a future model, none of this seems shocking. But we'd still take it with a grain of salt, particularly given the source doesn't currently have much of a track record. And although the reports above imply not much is changing on the Samsung Galaxy S26 Ultra, some other features of it might change, with prior leaks pointing to a variable aperture camera, a larger battery, and a significant performance bump. With Samsung's new foldables debuting in July, soon everyone, especially those who aren't into foldables, will be looking forward to the company's next Galaxy S flagship. The Galaxy S26 series will debut in early 2026, providing Samsung keeps to its typical launch timetable. And next year, it might debut four distinct models simultaneously instead of three. That fourth model may be the Galaxy S26 Edge. However, rumor has it that the Edge variation might replace the Plus model based on the S25 Edge's market success. For now, we're expecting Samsung will offer four variants, given the S25 Edge isn't performing well according to several sources. Details on the Galaxy S26's specifications are sparse, but one improvement is guaranteed: new processors behind the hood. The Snapdragon 8 Elite's replacement will likely power the Galaxy S26 Ultra and the Galaxy S25 Edge internationally. Samsung put tremendous effort into shrinking down its devices this year. The Galaxy S26 Edge is slim unlike anything else, and even the Galaxy S25 Ultra and mid-range smartphones, like the Galaxy A56, sport thinner designs than their predecessors. Samsung is also making the Galaxy Z Fold 7 its thinnest fold smartphone yet. According to reports, Samsung will continue the slimming trend with the Galaxy S26 design. Samsung will do this utilizing smaller camera modules. We previously saw this in action with the Galaxy S25 Edge. The S25 Edge includes a smaller 200 megapixels camera module than the S25 Ultra without any decrease in quality and capability. However, the general design is unlikely to alter to ensure the Galaxy brand preserves its identity. That implies a front side dominated by the display, aluminum frames on the base or plus versions, and titanium ones on the Galaxy S26 Ultra and S26 Edge, and a glass rear with individual camera modules on all save the Edge model. We would love to see Samsung outfit all models with Gorilla Armor glass for decreased reflection instead than only the Ultra. But it's not something we're optimistic about. We also don't foresee any changes to screen sizes. The S26, the S26 Plus, and the S25 Edge and S26 Ultra will most likely boast 6.2-inch, 6.7-inch, and 6.9-inch with AMOLED screens. The Galaxy S25 Edge may have avoided battery life issues if Samsung had utilized silicon carbon technology over the usual lithium-ion cells that power most smartphones, but it decided not to do so. Will it change next year with the Galaxy S26 series? That remains to be seen. But if the business did go with a silicon carbon battery, it might enhance battery capacity despite the slimmer chassis of the upcoming phones. The precise battery capacity estimates are not known as of May 2025. A rumor stated the S26 Ultra might include a 6,000 mAh battery, but we're doubtful since it seems too large of a leap from the 5,000 mAh batteries on older Ultra versions. The Galaxy S24 Ultra debuted a new 5x long-range zoom camera, and with the Galaxy S25 Ultra, Samsung launched a higher-resolution ultra-wide camera boasting a 50-megapixel sensor instead of a 12-megapixel sensor. However, although Samsung did improve the 10-megapixels front camera to a 12-megapixels one back in 2023, Samsung has kept with the same rear camera arrangement on the basic and plus Galaxy S devices for many years. Is that going to finally change with the Galaxy S26 series? Well, it doesn't look like it. While Samsung is equipping the S26 or S26 Plus with a new main sensor, it will retain the 50 megapixels resolution. And there is no news on whether the ultra-wide and zoom cameras will receive any improvement. In fact, a stunning report suggested that Samsung would defer releasing substantial camera advancements until the Galaxy S28. Even if Samsung doesn't wait that long, there's a high possibility there will not be any substantial camera advancements accessible on next year's range. That is likely to be true for the Galaxy S26 Edge in particular, given Samsung previously pushed things to a maximum by equipping the S25 Edge with a 200 megapixels primary camera. The Galaxy S26 series will ship with Android 16 out of the box, with version 8.5 of its One UI interface. Samsung will probably show off a new Galaxy AI capabilities, and one of them might be a rival to Google Gemini. Gemini supplanted Google Assistant and Bixby as the default digital assistant on the Galaxy S25 series and other smartphones that run Android 15 with One UI 7.0. And although it won't be going away, Samsung might offer Perplexity AI as an option. They are apparently working on an agreement to invest in Perplexity AI, a competitor to ChatGPT, and if the transaction goes through this year, it might very likely make its debut on the Galaxy S26 series. However, the business may only incorporate Perplexity into Bixby and the Samsung internet browser in the initial phase. While data on additional software enhancements is limited, we're hopeful the list of new features will be broader than it is for One UI 8.0. If not, we will need to wait for the Android 17 with One UI 9.0, which will be the first of at least 7 significant OS updates for the next Galaxy S flagship. Pricing is frequently the final critical piece of information to be announced, and that is unlikely to change with the Galaxy S26 series. For now, the only thing we can tell with any surety is that the pricing will stay the same as the Galaxy S25 range. However, the USA trade policies, namely Trump's tariff war, could force Samsung's hand into adding a higher price tag, even if the rise isn't huge. We'll know more before the end of 2025, so stay tuned. So, that's all we know for now. We'll be sure to keep you updated as soon as we have more information. Thanks for watching.